I have just a crucible inside of here that is melting about 20 pounds of clear glass, and it's running around 2200 degrees. We start with clear glass, or come in like little nuggets, and we melt them down, and it becomes a big puddle in our crucible. Toni Gerlach, Mind Blown Studio in Deadwood, South Dakota. Step into my studio. Just like our pipes over there, glass will stick to hot metal. We gather molten glass on the end of a 5-foot rod, and everything starts from there. Just depends on what you're making for the process from there. Glass color is, that comes in all different forms. So from like a powder all the way up to full bars to you can actually have a whole color tank. So it really just depends on what you're doing and how you're adding it. But most colors are just made out of different metals and minerals. A lot of our blues are made with like copper. A lot of our reds are made with gold. Very similar to like ceramic glazes. And then also too, our colors have different reactions. So it's not really like painting where you would take like red and blue and they would make purple. When those actually combine, they turn black. So there's actually a chemical reaction with it. And then shaping, I do a lot of solid work as well. Sometimes it doesn't always involve blowing, just shaping or manipulating the material into ideas you have. The most important part is when we're blowing glass, we want to get our glass nice and even on the end of the blowpipe. And then what we do to start a bubble in there, we actually blow a huge breath of air into the pipe and tap it in there with your thumb. And the heat of the pipe and the heat of the glass actually expands that trapped air and blows a bubble out through your soft material. The most important thing is to have your glass directly on center off the end of that pipe. If it's crooked a little bit, your bubbles will shoot out crooked. And then from there, your whole piece will be crooked. All glass has a different coefficient. So like the dishes that you use to bake with, it's like a Pyrex or a Boro. It's a harder form of glass, where this is actually a soft glass. And all those different coefficients of glass have different purposes for the glass. So like the glass that I make, we really wouldn't make like a coffee cup and put hot coffee in it. It could shatter or thermoshock it. Whereas your borosilica glass is a harder glass where it can actually handle those heat fluctuations. There's all kinds of science behind it. I'm constantly rolling the pipe. The glass always has movement to it right until we put it away. So once you get that left hand on autopilot, then your brain can focus on what the right hand's doing to shape it. We have a certain way to fold our newspaper. Basically, it just kind of folds into itself. We cut off a corner to let steam escape, and then we soak it in water, tar it a little bit so that it does have like a carbon layer over the top. And then the glass just basically floats on a steam and carbon layer. Never really touches the newspaper, but that's the closest way we can actually get to shaping the glass with our hands. Also, the newspaper allows us to cool certain areas so that other areas of the hot glass can expand so that you're shaping and cooling. You can actually get your glass too thin in certain areas or blow out a sidewall or blow out the bottom. So you're constantly watching the thickness of the material. And the newspaper allows you to also cool some certain spots. I appreciate the small town. I have regular customers. I've talked to everybody. So that is nice, and people do care about your craft and where you're going and what you're doing. I got started in glassblowing. I grew up in Las Vegas, and I was always really interested in art. My mother got me a glassblowing class when I was about 15, 16 years old, and I thought it was the coolest thing ever. When I was in my mid-20s, I decided that I wanted to be a glassblower as a career, and went to a school in San Diego that offered glassblowing. I moved up here in 2013. My family is originally from South Dakota, so my mom's from Deadwood, so I spent a lot of time up here growing up seeing my grandparents.
I wouldn't be where I am today without the help of my mother and stepfather. They're always encouraging me, and they have the can-do attitude, and anything is possible.
And when I moved up here, this Texaco gas station was available for rent, and it had been previously a coffee and deli shop before. And then I'm renting this space out, so we have a really good working relationship here. And now I'm able to focus a little more on my craft too. My passion really lies in kind of sculpting glass material. Glass does break, even after doing it for 10 years, usually break a piece a day. A lot of it's just trial and error. Figuring it out. Sometimes you open it up and you're like, wow, that's ugly. And then that's usually the first piece to sell the next day too. We're always the worst critics of our work.